germ cells are present, then sperms also present here, stem cells. Next one is, this is a pleiadic cells which is present on interstitium. It is called pleiadic cells. These also cut in this area. This area is called interstitium. This name is called pleiadic cell. This is called interstitium. This structure is called Sertoli cells. Now, pleiadic cells are also called as interstitial cell. Interstitial cell. Why it is called interstitial cell? Because of it located interstitium. Then, which produces male androgen. That is called testosterone. Okay, interstitial cells which produce male androgen. That male androgen produces male hormone. That male hormone is known as called testosterone. Now, pleiadic cells just only helps in sperms and which provide nourishment to the sperms. So now let us discuss about enlarged, the view of this spot enlarged here. Enlargement of this spot. So I will draw here enlargement. This is common. This red color, so layer is called basement membrane. This is called basement membrane. Alright, this is called basement membrane. On the basement membrane, okay, germ cells are produced. This is called germ cells. On the germ cells, germ cells. So this is sperms. This is sperms. Okay. Now see, let us discuss about internal structure of seminiferous tubule. This spot is known as called Sertoli cell. Then it is called germ cells. It is called germ cell. And after this outer layer of the seminiferous tubule is called basement layer. What is that? Basement membrane. Basement membrane. See here, germ cells are also called spermatogonium. Germ cells are called spermatogonium. Germ cells also called spermatogonium. Thus, gonium means mother. The mother cells, that means sperm mother cell. The sperm mother cell has diploid state, and that means the chromosome number is double here. That germ cell undergoes development by mitotic division. So here see, that is a mother cell. The sperm mother cell undergoes mitotic cell division, then become primary. This is called primary spermatocytes. Primary spermatocytes take place meiosis division 1, that means meiosis phase 1, then become differentiated into secondary spermatocytes. This under secondary spermatocytes, okay, undergoes division meiosis 2. Here take place meiosis 2, then form spermatids. That is a differentiated spermatids. So here see, this is called secondary spermatocytes undergoes meiosis 2 cell division take place, then form spermatids. Now transformation of spermatids into spermatozoa, am I right? Now transportation, that means transformation of spermatids into spermatozoa. What is that? Spermatozoa. By this process is known as called spermatogenesis. After spermatogenesis, what is the spermatogenesis? Formation of sperms within the seminiferous tubules is called spermatogenesis. But generally, that is a spermatids which is converted into spermatozoa is known as called spermatogenesis. That process is called spermatogenesis. Here spermatogenesis is young one. That spermatozoa means sperm. Here young sperm head is attached, that means embedded in the Sertoli cell. This is called Sertoli cell, which gets nourishment to sperms. Then after getting nutrition, automatically they are released into the cavity of seminiferous tubule. It is released into cavity of seminiferous tubule. This type of process is known as called spermiation. What is the spermiation? After spermatogenesis, the sperms get that nutrition from Sertoli cells, then finally reach into the cavity of seminiferous tubule is known as called spermiation. During this spermiation, the sperms released into epididymis from testes, then epididymis into where Vasa differentia, that is main important duct which carry the sperms into ejaculatory duct, that ejaculatory duct into urethra, then the urethra carry that sperms into outside of the penis. This is a process of spermiation. So next, let us discuss about the comparison between, so what is that, that means Sertoli cells and the Leydig cells. What is the comparison between Sertoli cells and Leydig cells? Sertoli cells and Leydig cells. That is hormone associated with so Leydig cell. Let's compare it. So here Sertoli cell stimulated by follicle stimulating hormone produced by anterior pituitary, very important. Sertoli cells, okay, stimulated by follicle stimulating hormone. That follicle stimulating hormone again produced by anterior pituitary. After stimulation of Sertoli cells, which produce two hormones. How many hormones? Two hormones, which is called One is inhibin, and another one is androgen binding protein. Am I right? Androgen binding protein. Shortly ABP. Inhibin function. This okay? Inhibin function is it control secretion. It control secretion of follicle stimulating hormone. Next, androgen binding protein function is it concentrates testosterone inside the seminiferous tubule. Inside the seminiferous tubule. That is function of androgen binding protein hormone. Inhibin function is it controls secretion of follicle stimulating hormone. Androgen binding protein hormone function, it concentrates testosterone inside the seminiferous tubule. Next, let's go. Now one more point is there. Sexual cell which provide the nourishment to the sperm, that's why it's called sustentacular cell. What is that? Sustentacular cell or nurse cell. Am I right? That is called nurse cell. Now another Leydig cell stimulated by luteinizing hormone. Am I right? Leydig cells are stimulated by luteinizing hormone. That luteinizing hormone produced by anterior pituitary part of brain. After secretion of Leydig cells, which produce male androgens, right? Male steroid hormone. That hormone is called testosterone. Testosterone also. Extra level of testosterone also produced when happened immediately by will give negative feedback. Androgens give negative feedback by controls. This is the comparison between Sertoli cells and the Leydig cells. Sertoli cells is known as called sustentacular cell. Why? Because which provide the nourishment to spores. Then Leydig cells which produce male steroid hormone. Sertoli cells provide nutrition, food to spores. And apart from that, which produce two types of hormone. One is inhibin, another one is a hydrogen binding protein. Which one is control concentration of testosterone inside the seminiferous tubule? Inhibin only controls secretion of follicle stimulating hormones. Then Leydig cell hormone is male androgen produced. That male androgen produced secreted this testosterone hormone. That is a comparison between Sertoli cells and Leydig cells also. This is a brief explanation about axis receptors. Now let us next class we are going to discuss about accessory ducts and accessory glands. What are the accessory glands? Seminal vesicle, prostate gland, then bulbo urethral glands also. Then after penis we have to discuss. Okay, next class.